Building on top of the previous episodes, we will add internationalization features as well as custom CSS to our UI5 app today. We start in our manifest.json file, where we define a new i18n model, which is short for internationalization. It's of type resource model, and our bundle name points to our project root plus an i18n folder and file, which we'll create next. By the way, we have defined our project root during the bootstrapping of our app in episode 1. Let's create the i18n folder and a file called i18n.properties. We will use this file to define the default text being displayed in our app. Let's set a text for our counter button before we create another file called i18n_de.properties and define the German translation for the same texts. Let's move over to our app view and use our new model. We use the data binding syntax to set a new text for our button. After restarting our app, we can see the new text for the button in English. But the great thing about the i18n model is that we can attach a query parameter to the URL of our app to change the language to German, or any other language we have provided translations for. Another great thing about UI5 is that it's possible to apply custom CSS. In our manifest.json file, we can define a new resource, which is CSS, and point to a folder and file, which we'll create next. Inside our CSS file, we define a few CSS styles for a class that we call BigText. We will assign this class to the text control next to our counter button in just a second. The specific values are set so that our text will be well aligned next to our button. All that's left for us to do is to go into our app view and assign the class. Let's refresh our app. As you can see, our new custom styles are applied. Let's continue the next episode.